limit n approaches to infinity, mn is equal to turning out to be 0, then our sequence would be uniformly convergent. So the result is... Good morning, class. So as you know, I'm Priyanka Godara, Maths Optional Faculty, Plutus IAS. And in this class, we are going to discuss MN test for the convergence or uniform convergence of sequences. MN test for uniform convergence of sequences. But before discussing the uniform convergence, what we know, we should know basic concepts of convergence. Na? We have two types of convergence. These are one is pointwise and another is uniform. What is the difference between pointwise convergence and uniform convergence? In pointwise convergence, what happens if, say, if we have a sequence Fn, sequence Fn is a sequence of functions defined on some interval, say AB, this is sequence of functions, so FnX would be better. On some interval AB, then we say that sequence FnX converges pointwise on AB. If, what is the condition? If for all x belonging to AB, that is for all x belonging to the interval AB, there exists some epsilon greater than 0. For all x belonging to AB and for any epsilon, epsilon greater than 0, there exists some positive integer m belonging to n such that mod of fnx minus fx is less than epsilon for all n greater than equal to m, where fx is limit function of the sequence. And how we find out this as limit n approaches to infinity fnx. So this is the definition for pointwise convergence. It says that a sequence fnx converges pointwise on interval AB if for every x belonging to, see these words that I am highlighting, that is for every x belonging to AB and for any epsilon, that is any epsilon, there exists m belonging to n such that the mod of fnx minus fx less than epsilon for all n greater than equal to m, where fx is limit function of the sequence, or sometimes we also call it as limit of the sequence. And it is find out as using the formula limit n approaches to infinity fnx, right? And then what is uniform convergence? This is pointwise convergence. Then what is different about uniform convergence? See here, epsilon, but this value of m, this m depends upon both x and epsilon. So the choice of m depends upon the point x which of which point x we are selecting from the interval and which epsilon we are choosing. So our m depends upon both x and epsilon. That means if I change some x here, then it would change epsilon, m would change accordingly. But if it is possible to find out some uniform m for every x, if it is possible to find out one m for all x belonging to AB, then we will say that this convergence would be uniform convergence, that only one m is working for all the values of interval AB. So then the convergence would be uniform convergence. And for checking out the uniform convergence, we have this test. This is known as Mn test. What does Mn test say? It says that if fn be a sequence of functions such that limit n approaches to infinity, fnx is equal to fx. This is limit function of our given sequence. And let this is Mn. They have defined some Mn, that is other sequence or some function, say Mn. It is what? Supremum x belongs to AB mod of fnx minus fx. Then we will say that fnx converges f uniformly on AB if and only if, that is, it is both way, mn approaches to 0 as n approaches to infinity. What does it mean? It says that if sequence is uniformly convergent, then this mn, whatever they have defined, this has been defined as supremum of fnx minus fx. This mn would tend to 0 as n approaches to infinity, or you can say limit n approaches to infinity, mn is equal to 0. So that is the thing. And if limit n approaches to infinity, mn is equal to turning out to be 0, then our sequence would be uniformly convergent. So the result is both way, that is, it is necessary and sufficient condition. Necessary by what means? That if it is uniformly convergent sequence, then limit n approaches to infinity would be 0, and if limit n approaches to infinity is 0, then sequence have to be uniformly convergent, right? So these necessary and sufficient condition, and we will discuss some of the examples based upon this question, this test, because this test frequently is being asked in our real analysis paper, that is real analysis unit in paper 2. And this on the alternate year or sometimes in the consecutive years also, this test is being asked. This test as well as Mr. Sam test, that is also on the YouTube. You can watch that video also. So this is the example. Prove that the sequence fn, where fnx is defined as we converges uniformly on any closed interval. So we are provided with fnx, and this is x over 1 plus n x square. Now what we need to do? We need to find out some mn, right? And what is mn? That is supremum of fnx minus fx. We require this thing, and after that we will check limit n approaches to infinity mn. So these are the steps that we require. We will check this. If it would be 0, then we will say that given sequence is uniformly convergent, and if it turns out to be non-zero, then we will say that sequence is not uniformly convergent, because the test is two ways, na? Okay, so first, our first task is to find out this mn, then we will check the limit. But before finding mn, we need to find out this fx. And what is fx? Fx is limit n approaches to infinity x over 1 plus n x square. How would you find out the limit? Take n common and then put the values of n as infinity. Limit n approaches to infinity. If I take n common, then it would be n over x over n into x square plus 1 by n. And x belongs to sum of the interval, or x is real. So it is not creating any difference if n approaches to infinity and this limit becomes 0. So fx is turning out to be 0. Now we need to find out MN. So MN would be supremum of what? FNX, that is x plus x over 1 plus nx square minus 0. And this is supremum of x over 1 plus nx square. Now this is a function, and how would you find out the supremum of a function? Supremum, if exists, would be maximum of the number, na? So can I write this as y, and then we will try find out maxima of this by using concept of maxima and minima. Say this is y, x over 1 plus n x square. Then what would you do to finding out the maxima and minima? First we have to take their first order derivative, then we will put that derivative equal to 0 and find out the critical point, right? And after finding out the critical points, those points would be extreme points, that is value of the function would be either maximum on those points or it would be minimum, right? So let's find out the critical points, and for that we need to differentiate this with respect to x. If I will do differentiation, it would be 1 plus nx square whole square into 1 plus nx square, that is u by v rule, na? 1 minus x into, and what is the differentiation of this? 1 would be 0 and it would be 2nx. So by solving, it gives us 1 plus nx square minus 2nx square divided by 1 plus nx square whole square. And this is nothing but 1 minus nx square divided by 1 plus nx square whole square. So this is y dash, and for critical points we need y dash is equal to 0. That means the denominator cannot be equal to 0, na? So our numerator would be equal to 0, and it would be, that means we need to find out x, that would be critical point. So what would be x? X is going to be 1 by plus minus, because this is x square, na? Root n. Now we need to check plus minus 1 at the values of x is equal to plus minus 1. We need to check second order derivative, and if second order derivative turns out to be negative, then we will say that this is point of maxima, and if second order derivative turns out to be positive, then we will say this is point of minima. So let's check that. First we need to do its second order derivative. Say something. Say this is 1, this is 2. Then we will say differentiating 2 with respect to x, and it gives us 1 plus n x square, its power 4. And it would be 1 plus n x square, its square on the upper side, and we have derivative of this upper part, that is minus of 2x n minus upper part as it is, and derivative the denominator. It would be, can I write 2 outside? Right here only. 2 into 1 plus nx square into derivative of nx square would be 2nx. So what can be taken common? 2 minus of 2nxn is here, 2xn is here, and with minus sign, then we have 1 plus nx square and 1 plus nx square. So can I take common? Minus of 2xn into 1 plus nx square. This is the minimum power of nx square, na? 1 is here, 2 is there. So we are left with, in the first part we have 1 plus nx square only, and from the second part we are left with, this is outside, this we have taken common, so n minus sign we have also taken common, this would be plus, and we are left with this 2 and this term, that is 2 minus 2 nx square divided by 1 plus nx square raised to power 4, and this would be cancelled out from here. So we are left with minus of 2xn, 3 minus nx square divided by 1 plus nx square and its power 3. This is double derivative, and we need to check its sign over our critical points. Let's check its sign over 1 by root n. So it would be y double dash f x is equal to 1 by root n. It becomes, if I substitute x is equal to 1 by root n, then we are getting n over root n. symmetry minus n over, if x is equal to 1 by root n, then x square would be nothing but 1 by n only. And in the denominator also, we have the same term, n into 1 by n, and it's cube. So the entire thing becomes minus of 2, we are left with under the root n on the upper side, and this would be 3 minus 1, that is 2, divided by 1 plus 1 cube, that is 8. So we are left with minus of root n by 4 into 2. So this is negative because n is natural number, na? N belongs to natural in sequence and series. But what is n? Domain. N denotes natural numbers because sequence, domain of sequences is always going to be natural, and hence n is natural number. So this is turning out to be negative. That means x is equal to 1 by root n is point of maxima. Right? And if it is point of maxima, then if you will check the point value of double derivative at x is equal to minus of 1 by root n, that would turn out to be positive, and that would be point of minima. But we require maxima, na? Hame to apne question ke liye maxima chahiye because we need supremum. So what would be mn? Mn would be supremum of this at, not supremum of this, this function at x is equal to, let me write on the next page. We don't have that space. So we will use inner. So what was mn? Mn was supremum of, let me see words, what is that? X over 1 plus n x square. X over 1 plus n x square. And we are getting this value at x over 1 plus n x square at the point x is equal to 1 by root n. So mn becomes, if I put this value, this would be 1 by root n divided by 1 plus n into 1 by n, and it is 1 by, this is 2 root n. So what was our next task after finding mn? After finding mn, we need to check limit n approaches to infinity mn, because this is the test, na? Supremum, you have found out mn, and then you need to check mn approaches to 0 or not. So we will check whether it is approaching to 0 or not. So check limit n approaches to infinity mn. And what is this? Limit n approaches to infinity 1 by 2 root n. And this is nothing but 0. Hence, our sequence fnx is uniformly convergent. And there is no restriction on any x, so it is uniformly convergent over R being any closed interval I, or you can say also real. So it would be uniformly convergent on I. Because there is no restriction on x, there is no restriction, we are not finding any of the restriction on x, so it is uniformly convergent throughout real. Okay, so this is how you need to proceed. First you need to find out fnx, then you need to find out fx, what is this, and then you need to define a function mn, and mn is supremum of fnx minus fx, right? And then you need to find out this supremum. And how would you find out? Most of the time you have to use this derivative kind of formula. That is, first you find out the critical point, after that check the second order derivative, and sign of that should be negative. If it is negative, then that would be, the point would be point of maxima, and the value of the function at that point would be our mn. And then you need to check the limit of this function mn, and if it is turning out to be zero, then your sequence would be uniformly convergent, and if it is turning out to be non-zero, then your sequence is not uniformly convergent. Should we do next example? Let's do, because this is past year question. It was asked in CSC 2019, and this is how, let me tell you how to proceed. So this is fnx, we require fx. What would be fx? Limit n approaches to infinity fnx, and that is limit n approaches to infinity, nx over, can I take n square common, because we need limit na, so maximum of n from the denominator should be outside, it would be n square plus x square, and this becomes limit n approaches to infinity, nx over, n would be cancelled out, so we are left with in the denominator n only, and this would be n square plus x square. If I put n is equal to infinity, this is going to be 0, so fx is 0. Now you need to define a function mn, and what mn is going to be? Mn is supremum of mod of fnx minus fx, right? So mn would be supremum of, what is fnx? Nx over 1 plus n square x square minus fx is nothing but 0. So you need to find out supremum of this function. So what will we do? Like the last example, we will say this is y, and if this is y, then it is going to be y is equal to nx over 1 plus n square x square, and now we need to find out the maxima of this. And for finding out the maxima, what we need to do, we have to put y dash is equal to 0. That means what is y dash? Y dash is 1 plus n square x square into 1 plus n square x square into derivative of the numerator, that is n only, minus nx into derivative of the denominator, and that is going to be 2n square x, right? 2n square x only, and this is going to be y dash is equal to this, y dash would be n plus n cube x square minus this 2 times n cube x square divided by 1 plus n square x square whole square, and this becomes y dash is equal to n minus n cube x square divided by 1 plus n square x square and its whole square. Now we need to put this y dash is equal to 0, and for that it would be n into 1 minus n square x square is equal to 0. That means x is equal to plus minus 1 by n we are getting. So x is plus minus 1 by n. And now we need to check these critical points whether they are point of maxima or minima. For checking maxima and minima, we need to check function sign at this function second order derivative signs at these points. So first we will find out what is the second order derivative, y double dash. Then you need to differentiate this equation, say this is star. By differentiating this, we are getting 1 plus n square x square and its power would be 4. So this is 1 plus n square x square whole square into minus of 2n cube x minus, can I take n common, but keep this only because we need to multiply ultimately. So, and from the denominator we are getting 2, 1 plus n square x square into 2n square x. And what it becomes, let me write here only so that we do have space for the next thing. Can I take common minus 2n cube x from here, as well as minus 2n square and 1n from here? That's why I was taking common. It would be 1 into 2 square. So it would be 2n cube x, this and this, if I take this common. And can I cancel this term and this term from the denominator? So we are left with 1 plus n square x square here minus, here we are left with this, we have cancelled from the denominator, and we are left with 2 times 1 minus, that is 2 only, and minus we have taken common, so 2 minus 2 minus here is 2n square x square, and in the denominator we do have 1 plus n square x square and 1 power we have cancelled, so we are left with 3 only. So our value is y double dash. Y double dash, it is turning out to be minus 2 n cube x, and we are left with, this is 3 minus, this is minus 2, this is plus 1, so we are left with n square, x square only, and in the denominator we do have 1 plus n square, x square, and its power 3. So we need to find, check the values at x is equal to 1 by n as well as minus 1 by n. If you will check at x is equal to 1 by n, then this is going to be minus 2 n cube by n, 3 minus n square into 1 by n square divided by 1 plus n square into 1 by n square, and it's 2. So it becomes n square, and this is 3 minus 1, this is 1 plus 1. So we are left with only minus 2 n square, and here this is 2 divided by 2 plus cube, 8. So this is again minus n square by 8. And if I do put n is equal to minus 1 by n, that would be positive. So we don't need positive values because that would be point of minima, but we require supremum na. So we require point of maxima, and hence x is equal to 1 by 3, not 1 by 3, 1 by n is point of maxima. And hence what would be mn? Mn would be value of y at 1 by n, and what is this? N into 1 by n from here na, say this is a, so using a, n into 1 by n, that is 1 plus n square by n square divided by 1 by n square, and it becomes 1 over 1 plus 1, that is 1 by 2. And if you will, this is mn is equal to 1 by 2. If you will check limit n approaches to infinity mn, this 1 by 2 is constant, and this is mn, this is going to be 1 by 2 only, which is not equal to 0. And if it is not equal to 0, that means it is the given sequence fnx is not uniformly convergent. Okay, so this is how you need to check the convergence and uniform convergence. That is, you were required to check, discuss the uniform convergence, and we reached the conclusion that it is not uniformly convergent because mn is turning out to be non-zero, and the mn test is both ways. That is, it works as if and only if. So if mn is not tending to zero, that means given sequence is not uniformly convergent, right? So we have some of the other example. This is also one of the example. It was appeared in the past year question. So either CSC mains, or it was IFOS mains. I don't know in which mains, but it is also one of the past year question. And let's try this one also. So here fnx is given as, show that the sequence this is defined by fnx is equal to nx plus nx into e raised to power minus nx square, where x is greater than equal to 0, is not uniformly convergent on 0 to k, where k is greater than 0. So how would you prove this? It is given that fnx is, first we need to find out limit n approaches to infinity fnx, because this would be fx na. Fx. Do you have any class? No, so first time you are joining, please give me 5 minutes, after that you can. Okay. Fx is equal to limit n approaches to infinity fnx is equal to this, and this is, then what would be this limit n approaches to infinity nx e raised to power minus nx square, right? And how would you find out the limit of this function? Say if I put n approaches to infinity, then n into nx into e raised to power nx square, this is giving us infinity, and what is this e raised to power minus infinity? That is 0. So this is 0 into infinity form na, and what is this? Indeterminate form. and how would you solve 0 into infinity form? You have to convert this either into 0 by 0 form or into infinity by infinity form. So what will we do? We will convert this into infinity by infinity form. And how would you convert this? Limit n approaches to infinity. I can write nx over, this is e raised to power minus x square. Can I write this way? E raised to power nx square. I can now. So now it is infinity by infinity format. And how would you solve infinity by infinity format? By applying L'Hopital rule. Hai na? L'Hopital or L'Hopital, whatever you want to say. And what would we do in that rule? We will differentiate with respect to n here, because limit n is approaching to infinity, so we will differentiate numerator and denominator separately with respect to n. And what it becomes? Limit n approaches to infinity, it would be x on the upper side, and in the denominator we do have e raised to power n x square into derivative with respect to n would be x square, and it becomes limit n approaches to infinity, x would be cancelled, 1 by x into e raised to power n x square. And now what is this 1 by infinity? So it is 0. So fx is turning out to be 0. And now you need to define mn, that is supremum of fnx minus fx. And what is this? Supremum of fnx n into nx e raised to power minus nx square. So directly we cannot find out the supremum of this function. So as earlier we will say this is y, and we will find out its first order derivative, then second order derivative. So y is nx e raised to power minus nx square. What would be its first order derivative? Y dash is equal to n, can I take outside? It would be e raised to power minus nx square plus x into e raised to power minus nx square into derivative of e raised to power minus nx square, that would be minus of 2nx. And for being critical points, y dash would be equal to 0. So from here we are getting this e raised to power minus nx square can be taken as common, and it would be 1 plus, this is not plus because we have minus inside, so we are getting 1 minus 2nx square, and this is equal to 0. E raised to power minus n square cannot be equal to 0 for real values of x, so we have 1 minus 2nx square is equal to 0. And that means n is equal to, not n, we need to find out x, at what values of x this is equal to maximum. So x would be plus minus under the root 1 by root 2 n. So this would be the point of, these would be critical points. Now we need to check sine of double derivative, and what would be double derivative of this? This is first order derivative, so we will do second order derivative. First derivative of this e raised to power minus n x square into minus of 2nx, second function as it is 1 minus 2nx square plus first function as it is and derivative of second. What is going to be derivative of second? Minus of 4nx, right? And can I take minus of 2 minus 2, n is already outside, 2nx I'll take common, so it would be minus 2n square e raised to power minus nx e raised to power minus nx square is also in the both the terms, so I have taken common, and this is outside, and we are left with 1 minus 2nx square. This we have taken outside, or yahan se bhi we have taken minus 2nx common, so we are left with only plus 2, and I'll make this 3. 1 plus 2 is 3. So this is our second order derivative. Now we need to check its sine as plus minus 1 by this. Let's check first its sine as x is equal to, these were critical points. X is equal to plus minus 1 by root 2 n. What it is going to be? Why did I say this? So minus 2 n square is n square as it is, x is 1 by root 2 n into e raised to power minus n into x square, that is 1 by 2 n 3 minus 2 n into x square, that is 1 by 2 n. So this would be cancelled, this would be cancelled, and this is minus 2, that would be root 2, and it would be n raised to power 3 by 2, right? And it is e raised to power minus half into 3 minus 1, that is 2. So entirely this is going to be negative, because this is negative, this is positive, this is positive. E raised to power, anything is always positive. E cannot be negative anywhere. Minimum value of e raised to power something is 0, na? So it is positive, all the terms are positive, we have extra negative sign. So this is entirely negative, and if it is negative, that means x is equal to 1 by root 2 n is point of maxima. And if it is point of maxima, then mn would be y at 1 by root 2 n. And what is that? Y at this. That would be 1 by n into x. At the place of x, we need 1 by 2 root n, root 2 n. Into e raised to power minus n into 1 by root 2 n its square, and it is going to be n by root 2 n, let's write this one, and it is e raised to power minus into n into 1 by 2 n. So this becomes root n by root 2 into e raised to power minus 1 by 2, and this is m. If I take limit n approaches to infinity mn, then this is going to be limit of this n approaches to infinity, this is going to be infinity na, and this is not equal to 0. Hence any it is not uniformly convergent on any closed interval that is 0 to k, where k is greater than 0. Hence given sequence or series fn is not uniformly convergent on 0 to k, where k is any number greater than 0. That is, you take any closed interval 0 to some positive number, it is never going to be uniformly convergent. And this was mn test. This is how we need to solve all the questions, okay? So this is very important, you have to do it definitely, because lot of time it comes into 15 markers. Thank you.